Hey everybody, Dan Cheney again, and welcome to another Music Charts Archive show here on DJN-TV. This show is scheduled to come out on the 59th birthday of George O'Dowd. However, you may know him better as Boy George. Today we'll count down his 10 highest charting songs, both as lead singer of the band Culture Club and as a solo artist. We'll see which song he jokingly referred to as ending his career, or ruining his career. We'll see which song Bob Dylan once maybe referenced in an interview. And if you're a fan of Adam Sandler movies, well, you've probably heard more than one of these songs. And we'll hear these songs and more on this week's edition of the Music Charts Archive Show.
DJ Event Planner will change the way you manage and run your business. Streamline all of your procedures and software into one easy-to-manage system. DJ Event Planner, the ultimate online planning tool.
Welcome to this week's Music Charts Archive Show. I'm Dan Cheney, and today we're counting down the highest charting songs by Boy George and Culture Club. So let's start that chart. At number 10, we have The War Song. Culture Club's third album was called Waking Up with the House on Fire, and it produced two top 40 hits. Mistake Number 3 peaked at number 33, and this song, which peaked at number 17 in November of 1984. The song had more success internationally, including peaking at number 2 in their native UK. Background vocals are provided by Claire Torrey, a session singer, whose most famous work is probably on Pink Floyd's album Dark Side of the Moon. Boy George has jokingly said that this song ruined his career, quote unquote, and it's often left off of compilation albums and was often left off the set list during performances. At number 9 on our list is The Crying Game, a Boy George solo song. Boy George charted two songs as a solo artist, and one was Live My Life in 1987, and then there was this song that got as high as number 15 in 1993. The Crying Game was originally recorded in 1964 by English singer Dave Berry. It was a top 10 hit in the UK for him. Boy George version was produced by the Pet Shop Boys, and it hit number 1 in Canada and Iceland. Both versions were featured in the 1992 movie The Crying Game and were played during the end credits. The song was also used in the movie Ace Ventura Pet Detective because of the comedic reference to the Crying Game movie. At number 8, we have It's a Miracle. It's a Miracle was the fourth and final single from Culture Club's second album, Color by Numbers. It peaked at number 13 in June of 1984. After the band's first six singles all went top 10 in the U.S., this was the first Culture Club single that did not make the top 10 in the U.S. However, it did make the top 5 in the U.K. and Canada. The song was actually first titled It's America, relating to the band's first trip to the United States. The video has the band playing around in a large circular Monopoly-type game board. Number 7 on our list is Move Away. Move Away was the first, or I'm sorry, was the final chart single in the US for Culture Club. It was from the album From Luxury to Heartache, and it peaked at number 12 in May of 1986. Phil Pickett co-wrote the song with the members of the band, and he also has a songwriting credit on the band's only number one hit, which we'll hear a little later on. The video for Move Away is set in a movie theater where movie posters, kind of come to life, and Boy George and John Moss appear as silent movie stars in racing cars. Boy George sang the song in a guest starring role in the TV show The A-Team, an episode called Cowboy George. And at number 6 on our list is Church of the Poison Mind. Church of the Poison Mind was the first single from the Color by Numbers album and peaked at number 10 in December of 1983. British singer Helen Terry sang background on the track, as well as several other tracks on that album. It's my understanding that the phrase Church of the Poison Mind refers to any organization you may belong to that wants to control what you think and control what you do. In an interview with Rolling Stone in June of 1984, Bob Dylan was asked if he belonged to any church, and he joked that he adhered to the Church of the Poison Mind. Welcome back, everybody. I'm Dan Cheney, and this week on the Music Charts Archive Show, we are counting down the 10 highest charting songs by Boy George and Culture Club. So let's get back into the top five. At number five is I'll Tumble For Ya. I'll Tumble For Ya is the third single from Culture Club's first album, Kissing to Be Clever, and it's their third top 10 hit from that album. It peaked at number nine in August of 1983. This song made Culture Club the first band since the Beatles to get three top 10 hits from their debut album. Supposedly, the band members took some tap lessons to perform a routine during the music video. You can see some very short clips of them trying to dance, but the full routine ended up being replaced and cut from the video. If you saw the Adam Sandler movie Billy Madison, you might remember him dancing on a staircase to the song. At number four, we have Miss Me Blind. This was the third single from the Color by Numbers album and their sixth consecutive top 10 hit in the U.S. In fact, it was their last top 10 hit in the U.S., peaking at number five in April of 1984. The lyrics contain a reference to the band's first album when Boy George sings, "I'm never really sure if you're just kissing to be clever." The video has the band in a Japanese setting, and when the song ends, a couple characters are trying to put out a fire with guitars. Background vocals are supplied by Jermaine Stewart, who actually had a top 10 hit of his own later in the 80s with the song, "We Don't Have to Take Our Clothes Off." Coming in at number three, we have Time, Clock of the Heart. The first two singles from Culture Club both peaked at number two, and this was the second. It hit the runner-up spot in June of 1983. In most of the world, it was a standalone single, but in North America, it was part of the Kissing to Be Clever album. It was kept out of the number one spot by Irene Cara's song Flashdance, What a Feeling. The music video has the band recording the song and making a video in the studio, and then presumably back home just relaxing, chilling out, and watching the video on TV while drinking coffee from some coffee mugs. Singer Helen Terry appears in the video, and Boy George has said that he didn't like the frumpy way that she was depicted in the video. Number two, we have Do You Really Want to Hurt Me? When Culture Club burst onto the scene in America, it was with this song. While watching the accompanying video, some people weren't quite sure what to make of the androgynous lead singer Boy George. The song reached number two in March of 1983 and was held out of the number one spot by Michael Jackson's song Billie Jean. Boy George wrote the lyrics and eventually admitted that they were about his relationship with drummer John Moss, along with other relationships that he's had, where George often felt hurt. Boy George didn't want the song released at first because it was so personal. The video has Boy George standing trial in a courtroom with flashbacks to eras where he didn't fit in or wouldn't fit in. And at number one, the highest charting song by Boy George and Culture Club is Karma Chameleon. The only number one song Boy George and Culture Club had in the U.S., Karma Chameleon was the second single from the Color by Numbers album and hit the top in February of 1984 for 3 weeks. Boy George wrote the song while on vacation in Egypt, and the band almost didn't want to record the song because they thought it sounded a little too country and Western for their style. In an interview, Boy George said that the lyrics are about the terrible fear of alienation that people have, the fear of standing up for one thing. It's about trying to suck up everybody, basically. If you aren't true, if you don't act like you feel, then you get karma justice. That's nature's way of paying you back. That's what Boy George said. Well, there you have it. Those are the 10 highest charting songs by Boy George and Culture Club. Please share the video and give us a thumbs up. Which of these songs are your favorites? Well, from this list, I think I'm going to have to pick Church of the Poison Mind. I can appreciate the song Do You Really Want to Hurt Me, but I always thought it was a little bit too slow for my taste. This has been Dan Cheney for the Music Charts Archive Show, and be sure to join us again next time right here on DJNTV.